Okay, we've marked out four holes there, 47 millimeters apart, and used the automatic center punch to mark the holes. You see I might have made a little mistake there, easily corrected once you measure and check everything out. So 47 millimeters apart, do a cross, mark the center. And a NEMA 23's got a 38 millimeter center, well, it requires a 38 millimeter center hole. I have a 40 millimeter hole saw, I think that'll be fine. So we'll drill this out and see how that works out. Here we've got the deck off, and you can clearly see the ball screw drive system. See how I've got it attached to the X gantry there. See the wiring coming from the y-axis motor number 2 on the rear right. It's the cable ties you see on the front piece of threaded rod there, all thread some of you people call it, booker rod. On the top there you see the articulated cable trunking, cable drag chain some people call it. You can also see the gearing down on the Z slide there. Got 5:1 gearing on that for error reduction and also for finer resolution. On the left hand side you'll see more articulated cable trunking and an attachment bracket. And just below that you can see a 20 millimeter fully supported linear rail. I chose mainly used 16 mil fully supported slide bearing there. I got the 20 mil really cheap, so I grabbed that as well, a little bit heavier, so I put that on the bottom. There's the wiring for the two y-axis motors and the x-axis NEMA 23 that's yet to be installed. Here's a view of the rear of the machine. Gives you a better look at the ball screw and the attachments and the drive systems. That's obviously another reduction drive on the y-axis. The all thread rod there, I use that to hold the distance between the two gantry support pieces, and I can adjust that to exactly the right distance apart. And yeah, it's the way to go, it gives you a bit of adjustment. Easy to align your machine. On the gantry you'll see the X axis ball screw. It's a 1605 type ball screw, 5 millimeter thread pitch. We'll show you, zoom right in. If you have a look at the back of that drive plate, you'll see it almost scrapes the gantry. There's probably about maybe not even half a millimeter clearance there. It was pretty close, but it doesn't scrape, so that's the main thing. It all fitted in quite well, and the machine is progressing along nicely. I hope to finish it in the next few days.